This video goes with the last portions of sections 100 and 102 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek, an intensive course, and it covers me verbs in the imperative and the infinitive. In Hansen and Quinn, you can find these topics on pages 347 to 349 and 372 to 378. Me verbs, as you already know, are different from thematic verbs in their first principal parts, their third principal parts, and in the case of histemi, in their fourth principal parts. Because it's those principal parts that we are concerned with, we only have to worry about the things that those principal parts do. We've now covered the indicative from the first principal part, as well as the subjunctive and the optative, in earlier videos. This video will cover the present infinitive, active, middle, and passive, and the present imperative, active, middle, and passive. We'll save the participle for the future. From the third principal part, we've done the aorist indicative, subjunctive, and optative, and now it's time for the aorist infinitive and aorist imperative, both active and middle. And this video will also cover, for histemi, the perfect infinitive. So let's start with the present imperative active for athematic verbs, me verbs. It's present, so it'll be first principal part plus some endings, and we're imperative, so we only need second and third person. The endings are the, e, or nothing, to, ta, and ntone. You'll learn as part of your vocabulary and part of learning each individual word which second person singular ending you need. So in this video, you'll learn which ones you need for didomi, histemi, and tithemi. We have to choose which grade of stem to use for the imperative, and since we are not indicative, we know that we'll be using the short grade stem. So let's put those in, and then let's see what happens here. The first thing we have to do is combine the e ending, which is the second person singular present imperative active you already know, with the short stem of didomi, and treat it as an omicron contract, and we get didu. With tithemi, we do the same thing. Let me show you that again. We treat the short stem of tithemi as an epsilon contract, and we combine it with the e of the imperative second person singular that you already know, and contract it, and we get tithe. And then with histemi, instead of putting an ending on it, we simply use the long grade stem. So there are the three imperatives that you have to know now in the second person singular. The first two, didomi and tithemi, actually use your thematic ending and do a contract verb sort of thing. And for histemi, you have to know not to use the short stem, but simply the long grade stem without an ending. The other endings go on as you would expect for athematic verbs, and they simply go on to the short stem and are pretty regular. And then we're going to put on recessive accent, which is already there for you, and we get didu, didato, didate, didantone, tithe, titheto, tithete, tithentone, histe, histato, histate, histantone. And that's the present imperative active. Now, the the will get used for some athematic verbs, and you'll have to learn those when you learn those new verbs, but it will come up and fairly soon. Okay, now, if we switch to the aorist, then we're going to need the third principal part plus endings. Then we need to remember that we're going to take the augment off of that third principal part. And to get the third principal part stems, of course, we also remove the iota reduplication from the first principle part. Now, for the imperative, we're going to use two different rules for the stems, in fact. So for the mixed aorist imperatives, for ditto me and tithe me, we'll actually use the short grade stems as the rule says. But for histe me, we're going to use stay, the stem of the root aorist. So I've just removed those beginning reduplications and turned almost all of the stems of the root aorist into long. The long stem actually shortens before the new tau of the third person plural ending, but I'll remind you that again in a moment. Now we actually have then two different endings for the second person singular of the aorist imperative. For the mixed aorist, we get a sigma. For the, oh, and there they go, dos and thes then are the second person singular, excuse me. And then for the root aorist, we get thi. And here it goes on. The accent is recessive, and so I'll put the rest of the accents in. And we get dos, dato, date, dantone. So give, let him give, y'all give, and let them give. Thes, theto, theta, thentone. So place, let her place, y'all place, and let them place. And then we get, for the root aorist of histe me, we get stathi, stand, stato, let him stand, stata, y'all stand, and stantone, let them stand. So again, the eta of the long grade stem of the root stem of histe me in the aorist shortens before that particular consonant combination. Much of the aorist imperative active then is exactly like the present imperative active, just without the reduplication on the beginning. Your troublemakers are the second person singular. And this makes some sense, since imperatives in the second person singular are probably the forms that get used the most as you boss people around, and therefore they become the least regular. Let's move on. The present imperative middle passive for athematic verbs comes, of course, from the first principle part. And these are the endings. As you can see, those are the person markers without thematic vowels for the middle passive and the imperative. And we're going to use the short grade stems and simply put those endings on. And this time in the middle and passive, it's quite regular. And once we put the recessive accent on, we get didasa, didastho, didastha, didasthone, tithasa, tithastho, tithastha, tithasthone, histasa, histastho, histastha, histasthone. When we move on to the aorist imperative, and now, of course, just middle, will be in the third principle part. We will take the augment off, and we will actually also change one of the endings. As you saw, the sigma disappeared from the second person singular. Like I said, the second singular often is more irregular. So as we transform these present forms into aorist forms, I'm going to go ahead and take off that wrong second person singular on all three verbs. We will take off the augment, and we will get rid of the of histe me entirely, because of course estesa is the only place you get aorist imperative middle for histe me, and you already know those forms. So returning to the verbs that we are going to use, ditto me and tithe me, we're going to do that thing where we shorten the stem. And so let me do that to our actual verbs in the paradigm. And now with that omicron of the second person singular middle, with the da of the short grade aorist stem of ditto me, it's going to act like an omicron contract. And when we put that ending on, we're going to get do, because it's going to, the two omicrons are going to contract. And the same thing is going to happen when we add the omicron to the short grade stem of tithemi in the aorist, tha, and it's going to behave as an epsilon contract with that omicron and contract to thu. When we put the recessive accent on, we get do, dostho, dostha, dosthone, thu, thestho, thestha, thesthone. So, in all but the second person singular, these forms are like the present imperative, just without the initial reduplication. It's just that second person singular that you need to know the exceptions for, and they can be quite different for each verb. And now we get to move on to the present infinitive active for athematic verbs. Here we will do the first principal part with the short grade stem, and we will add one ending for the infinitive active, and that ending is nigh. So if I put in the short grade stems from the present first principal part and add the infinitive ending nigh, we get these forms. And here you need to know that the accent is fixed in the syllable right before the nigh. And so we get didonai, tithenai, and histonai for the present infinitive active. If we go on to the aorist infinitive active, we have to remember that we have two behaviors for the aorist infinitive. We've got two mixed verbs and we've got one root verb. So for the mixed verbs, we'll use the short grade from the third principal part. And for the root verb, of course, that's always the long grade. We remove the augment and we add the ending. Now, there's only one infinitive ending. You don't have to learn a whole paradigm, except that we're going to have two different endings for the different varieties of aorist in the me verbs. So for the mixed aorist, you get ni. And for the long grade root aorist, you get nigh. So I'm going to put in the stems. And once again, that ni that is going to combine with the short grade stems of ditto me and tithe me as if those were contract verbs. So da plus ni contracts and becomes dunai. Tha plus ni contracts and becomes thenai. But with histemi, with the root aorist, all you do is put the ending on and nothing else has to be done. Again, the accent is fixed in the syllable before the nai, and so following the regular rules for accent, those will be circumflexes, dunai, thenai, and stenai. Before we leave infinitives active, we have to remember that histemi also is going to give us an unusual perfect infinitive active. So here it's principal part 4, and the short grade stem plus our active infinitive ending, which is once again nigh. So here's our short grade stem from hesteka, hesta, plus nigh. Accent is fixed on the syllable before the nai, like this, and you get hestanai. Now for the present infinitive middle passive for athematic verbs. First principal part and the short grade plus the ending. Sthai is the ending that you'll recognize from earlier middle and passive infinitive endings, but this time there's no thematic vowel on the beginning of it. With the short grade stems, then, all we do is add that ending and recessive accent, and you get didasthai, tithasthai, and histasthai. When we move on to the aorist infinitive middle for athematic verbs, we're going to use the third principal part, and of course we're only going to do the mixed aorist verbs, didomi and tithemi. And the ending is thai again. And with these stems, we simply add the ending with recessive accent, and we get dosthai and thesthai. Once again, there's no special aorist infinitive middle for histemi, because the only middle forms come from a regular first aorist, sigma alpha aorist, este sa, and so we don't need to learn any new forms. And there you have all of the imperatives and infinitives for the unusual forms of me verbs.